Hi everyone, my name is Manuel Ricker. I'm a postdoctoral researcher at ETH Zurich in Switzerland. And in this talk, I'm going to present you pivotal queue synthesis, or short PQS, which is an approach that we have devised to automatically test database management systems in order to find logic bugs. In our work, we mainly considered relational DBMSs such as SQLite, Postgres, and MySQL. And to illustrate how widely they are used, I want to pick SQLite as an example. SQLite is an embedded database system that is used within all of our mobile phones, web browsers, in many embedded applications, and the author speculated that there are over 1 trillion SQLite databases that are in active use. Thus, it is crucial that these database management systems work correctly, because a single bug might affect many users in practice. In our work, we found close to 100 unique, previously unknown bugs in these DBMSs, the majority of which have been fixed. In our work, we primarily wanted to find logic bugs, which are bugs for which the DBMS returns an incorrect result set. We believe that these bugs are important and difficult to find, given the scope of today's databases, and also because, for example, unlike crash bugs, here only silently an incorrect result is computed without the user knowing that the result is incorrect. Now let us consider a specific example of a test case that triggered a bug in SQLite and which was automatically generated by our tool. You can see here this create table statement, which creates a table. Next, we have this create index statement, which creates an index, which is an auxiliary data structure to speed up query processing. Then we insert some data into the table, and finally, we issue this select statement to the database system, which represents the query. Now, all the rows for which this where clause evaluates to do should be fetched. The where clause here uses this isNot operator, which is a null safe comparison operator, meaning that even if one of the operands evaluates to null, the operator will still return a Boolean value. So for which row or which rows should be part of the result set? Zero isNot one evaluates to true, so it should be part of the result set. One isNot one evaluates to false and will be omitted. Two isNot one evaluates to true, and also null isNot one evaluates to true. So if you execute this test case using the latest version of SQLite, this is the result that you will get. Now the latest version at the time when we evaluated our tool, SQLite was affected by a bug that actually caused it to omit null from the result set. We reported this bug to the SQLite developers, who quickly fixed the bug and stated that it was introduced in 2013. So what existing techniques could we consider to test database management systems to find logic bugs? I believe that the most impactful and most effective one still goes back to around 2000. Where Microsoft Research proposed to use differential testing in this domain. The idea here is basically that we generate one test case that is sent to multiple DBMSs, for example, here Postgres, MySQL, and SQLite, each of which returns a result set, which we could then compare. If the result sets differ, then we likely have found a bug in one of these DBMSs or multiple. Now, we found in practice that already for the example that we considered, this would result in or would highlight differences in the SQL dialects because Postgres and MySQL return a syntax error for the test case. Why? Because first of all, for this create table statement, we did not include a data type which is not needed for SQLite, but actually MySQL and Postgres require a data type definition. MySQL and Postgres also do not understand this isNot operator. So Postgres provides an isDistinctFrom operator with the same semantics, and MySQL provides a null safe comparison operator that we could negate to obtain the same semantics. But you can already see that from this simple example that using differential testing gets quite tricky and doesn't allow to test extensions that each DBMS provides. In order to find logic bugs, we propose pivotal query synthesis, or short PQS, which is a divide and conquer approach for testing DBMSs. Specifically, our core idea is that we only want to validate the result based on one randomly selected row from the database. And we refer to this row as the pivot row. We then generate a query that is guaranteed to at least fetch the pivot row, potentially among other rows in the table. And finally, we check whether the pivot row is part of the result set. If it is not, if it is omitted, then we have found a bug in the DBMS. And this approach would have already allowed us to find the bug in our motivating example, because we can select null as a pivot row, generate this query that is guaranteed to fetch it, to then discover that it's actually omitted from the result set. Now, in detail, our approach works as follows. First, we randomly generate a database. For this, we consider various statements that are specific to the database management system under test. So basically, we implemented database generators for each DBMS manually. This is actually not a contribution of our approach. A number of existing database and query generators exist that work similarly. Next, we select a random pivot row. And although it is only a single row, it might refer to multiple tables and views. Subsequently, we generate a query for each for the pivot row, so a query that is guaranteed to fetch the pivot row. And here our insight is that we only need to generate predicates and force that they evaluate the true for the pivot row to then use them in verb and join clauses. So to detail this, we could consider that first we randomly generate the verb clause of our motivating example, and we implemented an expression evaluator for each node that we support. And based on this expression evaluator, we can then evaluate the tree based on the pivot row. Meaning that column references, they return the values from the pivot row. Here, C0 returns null. The other kind of nodes, or the other kind of leaf nodes, are constant nodes which return their assigned literal value. So here, 1. And compound nodes compute the result based on the children. So here, since null is not 1, this would return true. Since the predicate already emulates to do for the pivot row, we can use it in the verb clause. Alternatively, we could also have used it in a join clause. But what do we do if the expression does not emulate to true? For this, we have a simple rectification step. So if the expression emulates to false, we just negate it. And if it emulates to null, we append this is null operator. Alternatively, we could also validate that the pivot row is expectedly omitted from the result set if the expression evaluates to false or null. Besides the core query semantics, we also considered additional clauses, for example, the distinct clause, which excludes duplicate rows, which we do not check using our approach. We also randomly generate order by clauses, which might put some additional pressure on the query optimizer, but do not or only influence the ordering of the result, which we do not check. And as another example, we considered various DBMS-specific clauses, for example, the for update clause that MySQL supports and which doesn't influence the result set. And finally, we validated that the pivot row is contained in the result set. For this, we use SQL and let the DBMS check. For SQLite, we can use the intersect operator. And basically, if here the pivot row values on the left side are included in the query on the right hand side, then the result set returned by this overall query will be non-empty, which we can easily check. After this, we can continue with either of the steps. So we can continue by randomly generating another database. We can select a new pivot row or generate another query that is guaranteed to fetch the pivot row. By default, our tool generates 100,000 queries for each generated database, because we found that generating a database is more costly than issuing queries. We implemented our approach in a tool called SQL Answer, which is available on GitHub, and also went through the artifact iteration process. So if you're interested in this work, then please check it out. We evaluated SQL Answer on three DBMSs, namely SQLite, MySQL, and Postgres. In this process, we found close to 100 unique, previously unknown bugs. You might have noticed that we found most bugs in SQLite, one main reason being that the SQLite developers quickly responded to all of our bug reports. They typically fixed all bugs within a day, which is why we focus testing on this DBMS. So our PQS implementation is most complete for this database system. Of all bugs that we found, 61 were logic bugs. And next, I want to present you one example for each DBMS. Here you can see a test case that triggered a bug in SQLite. It consists of mainly fairly standard statements. The only one you probably might not be familiar with is this analyze statement, which gathers statistics about the tables, which are then used by the query planner. When we tested SQLite, only a single row was returned, and the pivot row that SQL answer chose at this time was omitted from the result set. After reporting the bug, the SQLite developers stated that this was a bug in one of the optimizations, namely the skip scan optimization, which caused the pivot row to be omitted. So the SQLite developers classified this bug as severe and quickly fixed it, and now SQLite returns the correct result, which has a cardinality of 3. Now in Postgres, we only found a single logic bug, and this bug was related to inheritance. So you can see here that table T1 inherits from table T0. And if we insert a value into T1, it will get inserted into both T1 and T0. Now you might notice that T0 has a constraint on the column C0, namely a primary key constraint, and this typically prevents duplicate values from being inserted. Now, due to the inheritance relationship, actually this primary key constraint is not enforced and the duplicate value here is inserted. This was not respected by this group by clause, or not regarded by this group by clause, where basically an optimization caused the group by C1 to be optimized away. After we reported this bug, it was quickly fixed, and now Postgres also returns the 0-1 row, which we would have expected to be part of the result set. For MySQL, you can see here a case where we use a double negation in the predicate, and it is actually a textbook optimization to remove these double negations. Now, what we discovered is that for MySQL, this optimization actually doesn't work because MySQL has quite a flexible type system and allows, for example, integers as input for the NOT operator. In this case, the integer will be converted to a Boolean before the operation is applied. So by optimizing away this double negation, the work loss evaluated to false, which was then fixed quickly by the MySQL developers. Besides logic bugs, we also found a number of error bugs and also crash bugs. So error bugs are bugs that are due to unexpected internal errors. One example here is for SQLite, where a query unexpectedly returned the error message database disk image is malformed, hinting towards the database being corrupted. So one potential concern about our technique is that the implementation effort for implementing the expression evaluators might be high. And here our observation is that in order to realize this, we need to implement a literal evaluator, which is simpler than implementing EST interpreters for programming languages because we do not need to deal with mutable state, and also simpler than query engines because we only need to consider a single row at a time and also need to deal with the storage layer of the DBMS. Furthermore, we observed that the performance of the DBMS is the bottleneck and not of the tool. So all the operators are implemented very naively in our testing tool. But the implementation effort required to implement functions such as printf and complex operators is high. So here we believe that our technique is mainly applicable to test the core semantics of the DBMS. Some other limitations include that in order to realize the technique, a detailed understanding of the SQL semantics of the respective DBMS is necessary. So we implemented the expression evaluators based on the documentation of the respective DBMS. Our approach is not applicable to testing aggregate and window functions, which compute the result over multiple values, because we only consider a single row at a time. We also do not check for the ordering of the results, and PKS cannot distinguish between duplicate rows that are omitted or erroneously fetched from the result set. Now, one question that we often get is about the importance of the bugs that we reported. So first of all, the SQLite developers, which assigned severities to our bug reports, classified a number of our bugs as critical, important, and severe. But here I have some anecdotal evidence that even shows that bugs that are might not be considered important might still matter in practice. You can see here a test case that was reported by a user on the SQLite mailing list, and another user responded to this user basically saying that that they cannot mean or they wouldn't want to write such code in production because the work clause is unnecessarily complex. And the user defended themselves, saying that this was actually automatically generated by middleware and not written manually. By the time, the bug had actually already been fixed because we reported the bug before the users did. And I believe this gives some evidence that even such bugs that might be considered as obscure might affect users in practice, for example, when the code is automatically generated. Pivot query synthesis was our first testing approach to find logic bugs in DBMSs. Since then, we have continued our testing work and came up with two additional approaches. Non-optimizing reference engine construction, or NOREC, allowed us to find over 150 bugs in widely used DBMSs. And here our insight was that we wanted to find an important subcategory of logic bugs, namely optimization bugs, by rewriting a given query so that it cannot be optimized by the DBMS. Ternary logic partitioning is an approach where we partition a given query into several partitioning queries whose result set is then combined and which is applicable to test various features. Both of these approaches are metamorphic testing approaches, and the implementation effort required to realize them is lower compared to PQS, but they are also more specific and cannot find a number of bugs that a PQS can actually find. SQL Answer now also supports a number of additional DBMSs, some of which are contributed by third parties. So we are grateful, for example, to Yandex, who contributed ClickHouse, and to Citus Data, which is now part of Microsoft, who contributed a Citus implementation. And with that, I want to wrap up the talk. I've presented to you that we tackled the problems of finding logic bugs in our work. We came up with PQS, a technique that is based on the intuition that we want to validate the DBMS based on only a single row in the database. And our approach basically randomly generates expressions that are then enforced to evaluator 2 so that we can use them in where and join clauses of our of the queries. Overall, our technique is highly effective and also general, as we demonstrated on our implementation of an evaluation of three widely used DBMSs. With that, thanks for listening, and I would be very happy to answer any questions that you might have. Thank you.